In this video, we're going to take a look at the difference between lone pair electrons and bonding pair electrons. And note that sometimes lone pairs are called unshared pairs of electrons or non-bonding pairs. So these are all the same thing, just some different names. So let's start out with ammonia, NH3. The electrons between atoms, those are the chemical bonds right here. These are our chemical bonds, and these are called bonding pairs. So our bonding pairs right here between the atoms. What about this up here? It's not shared. It's not between atoms. It's an unshared pair of electrons, a non-bonding pair. Or you guessed it, this here, that's our lone pair. So a lone pair is not between atoms. And it's kind of important in chemistry. One of the reasons is molecular geometry. Let's take a look at that for NH3. Let's consider the purple here to be the nitrogen. Remember, we had three hydrogen atoms, and they were bonded. We had bonding pairs of electrons between the hydrogen and the nitrogen. So there's one, and the line here, that represents a bonded pair of electrons. Two electrons, one pair. We had three hydrogen atoms, and you can see they've spread out. They're all spread out because we have an electron cloud around the nucleus of the hydrogen here, and those electron clouds push away. But don't forget that lone pair. That's important. So let's put the lone pair here, and we do that, you can see that it's pushed them down. And because of that, it's changed the shape. Let's remove the lone pair. Watch what happens. Right now, it's flat. This is a trigonal planar molecule. That's the molecular geometry. We put that lone pair there, and it pushes everything down there. Now we have a trigonal pyramidal molecular geometry. So lone pairs, they occupy space, and they affect the molecular geometry. Let's go back. So we had our bonding pairs represented by the lines, and then our lone pair here, we saw how that affected the molecular geometry. So now you try one. Here's a Lewis structure for water. Identify the lone pairs and the bonding pairs of electrons. So remember, bonding pairs, they're between atoms, they're forming the chemical bonds. Lone pairs, or unshared pairs of electrons, non-bonding electron pairs, they are by themselves. So we have our lone pairs and our bonding pairs of electrons. But what do you think the molecular geometry here will look like since we have two lone pairs? Let's take a look at that. So H2O, this will be our oxygen here in the center, two hydrogens, and they're on either side here, spread out as far away as they can. And this is our bonding pair of electrons here and here. We add one lone pair, pushes everything down. Let's add one more. That's our second lone pair. And now we have this bent molecular geometry. So again, lone pairs occupy space and they influence the shape or the molecular geometry of a molecule. Let's go back. Sometimes you'll see the Lewis structure for water written like this. And that's to show that we have the bent molecular geometry. So to wrap up, our lone pairs are by themselves. The bonding pairs, they're between atoms. And lone pairs are important in chemistry. They influence the molecular geometry and even things like the reactivity, acidity, and even hydrogen bonding in molecules like water. This is Dr. B looking at the difference between lone pairs and bonding pairs of electrons. Thanks for watching.